The situation in India is beyond heartbreaking.
We are trying to save the life of all these people.
Many, sadly, are dying every day, literally unable to breathe.
Hospital, no more beds. No more beds in hospital.
India at breaking point. The world finally coming to its aid.
The United Kingdom is going to send to India oxygen compressors and ventilators.
We will provide raw materials for the production of AstraZeneca.
500 non-invasive ventilators, 1 million surgical masks, 500,000 P2 and N95 masks.
As long as this virus is spreading anywhere, it is a threat to people everywhere.
Today, Australia moved to minimise that threat.
We agreed to pause direct passenger flights between India and Australia until the 15th of May.
8 repatriation flights due to fly in from India in May have also been halted.
We know that for Australians in India and their loved ones, this is a very difficult time.
Australia's 500,000-strong Indian population, one of the largest in the world, devastated by the news.
So it has become as a most stressful situation for us. We don't know how to actually live into a normal life now.
Hardip and Munit haven't seen their baby girl since Munit took Ziva to India to meet the grandparents at 2 months old. When COVID hit, she flew home early with her other daughter, Oisin.
It was hard to carry both of them together in the same flight, and we had a mutual decision that let's do one thing. I bring one back with me as I was supposed to join my job, and then later, after 15 days or 20 days, we can book flights for our in-laws and the younger one so that they can come together. But then I never thought that, you know, the moment I reached here, I got to know that the border has locked down and there will be no flights from India. There will be no flights from anywhere, actually.
The grandparents have been trying to get into Australia with little Ziva, now 18 months old, ever since.
We are missing that moment of seeing her growing. We miss that moment when she was teething. We miss that moment when she started walking. We miss that moment when she started saying, Mama.
My mother and my father, so she sometimes called them Mama and Dada. And that's something like we can't change.
Hardip, terrified that if something happens to his parents, Ziva could be in trouble.
If they catch COVID, who will be taking care of my daughter? That's what is my question now.
The family pleading, like so many others in their position, for help.
Australia is what we call home, and this is our country as well. And we have to save our country.
But definitely. We even want our family to be here.
We really
need them.
Ziva!
You know, we miss those things in our life. We miss having her in our arms. I miss that time when I could hug her, hold her.
And there'd be so many stories like that. Yeah. And seeing that vision of India, like, it's another reminder, not that we keep needing it, just how fortunate we are in Australia, which is why the lengths everyone's going to keep our country safe. But then there has to be compassion in there somewhere. Like, how do you work out...
separated from
their parents.
Well, there's stories worse than that. Like, I heard a story today of someone who needs surgery. They've got it booked. Like, and it's serious surgery. If they can't get back, they miss that. So, like, that's doing serious damage to that person. But you're right, that the flip side of it is terrifying. Like,
right.
You look at what's there.
But then the flip side of it, to the extension of that is too, that if you take all the people who want to get out of India, then you become India. If you can't, don't
argument.
Have a manageable quarantine system or
so,
whatever.
So what are we saying then? Are we saying that there should be a bar set for...
compassionate
spaces?
Ground.
Yeah, and then do you just get arguments over where you set that bar?
Yeah,
and then there's someone...
They're already allowing people to and from places on compassionate grounds. But
yeah.
I guess in India's situation...
Kids separated really from parents surely has to be a line that we...
Yeah, but what isn't compassionate grounds? Old parents, you know...
Surgery.
Yeah, surgery. Like, everyone's... desire to come home is compassionate, isn't it? Compassionate grounds.
Yeah, it's a question of degree and where you draw those lines. I'm glad I'm not the one who has to make those decisions, but those sort of situations are intolerable.
Yes, it's hard.
Well, speaking of coming home...
From expert opinions to in-depth analysis and reporting, the Project YouTube brings you the biggest stories from Australia and around the globe. Hit the subscribe button now for news delivered straight to your feed.